NETStudy 2.0, Determination in Process, Minnesota Department of Human Services, Office of Inspector General, Background Studies Division. Welcome to the training video on tracking the status of background studies using the Determination in Process queue. This training video contains some of the main functionality of the NETStudy 2.0 system. Due to ongoing refinements to the system, you may see slight variations between the screens shown in this video and the version of NETStudy 2.0 you will use. For this video, and in the NETStudy 2.0 system, the term provider refers to the NETStudy 2.0 user at the program, facility, educational program, or other entity that initiates background study applications. To go to the Determination in Process queue, in the upper left corner of your screen, hover your mouse over the Applications tab in the toolbar. Then, in the drop-down, click Determination in Process. The Determination in Process queue contains applications that have been submitted in the NETStudy 2.0 system. This queue allows you to track the status of background studies which have been successfully submitted, but a determination has not been completed. Background study subjects whose applications are in this queue have either not yet been fingerprinted or DHS needs more time to complete the background study determination. Please note that once a study subject has been fingerprinted, applications will remain in this queue for some time. The status column on this screen shows the statuses of each application. In process indicates study subjects who have not been fingerprinted. Fingerprints taken refers to study subjects who have been fingerprinted, but a background study determination has not been completed. The process to complete the background study determination begins when the study subject is fingerprinted and photographed. You may also withdraw an application from this queue if you choose not to move forward with hiring the study subject, or if the study subject self-selects out of the hiring process. First, you must remove the study subject from the roster, because study subjects are automatically added to the roster of the provider under which the application was submitted. To remove the study subject, click Remove from Roster in the Affiliation Status column. When the Terminate Affiliation box displays, record the separation date as the date in which the affiliation ended, and click Save in the lower right corner of the box. Then, click the Withdraw button under the Action column, and the Confirm Withdraw box will appear. Choose the reason for withdrawing the application from the Withdraw Reason dropdown, and click the Withdraw button in the lower right corner of the box. Notice that the application is now removed from the queue, and you will no longer receive communication from DHS concerning this application. If you wish to reaffiliate this study subject with your provider in the future, a new background study application must be submitted. Remember that if you choose to withdraw the application, the study subject may not provide direct contact services. Also in this queue, you are able to see whether a study subject must be supervised. Status types in the Supervision Required column are Yes, No, Remove, NA for not applicable, or Cannot Enroll for applications submitted by personal care provider organizations. Most study subjects are required to be supervised after the application is submitted in NETStudy 2.0, and the Supervision Required column will reflect Yes. Except for study subjects whose background studies have been submitted for a personal care provider organization. For PCPO studies, the supervision status will be cannot enroll until a background study determination of eligible is made, if applicable. For study subjects who do not receive a determination within 3 business days after being fingerprinted and more time is needed to complete the background study, the supervision status may remain yes if supervision is required, change to no if supervision is not required, or change to remove if the study subject is ordered removed while the background study is being completed. In addition to the displayed supervision status, a notice stating more time is required to complete the background study will be available on NETStudy 2.0. The study subject will receive this notice through the mail. This notice will include whether the study subject may provide services, either supervised or unsupervised, or if the study subject must be removed. For more information regarding notices, refer to the video about background study notices and documents. A link is in the description below. Once DHS completes the background study determination, the application will move from the Determination in Process queue to the Determination Available queue. For more information, refer to the video on how to manage the Determination Available queue. A link is in the description below. This concludes the training video on managing the Determination in Process queue. Thank you for your interest in this portion of NETStudy 2.0. Additional information is available in the NETStudy 2.0 user manual. To access the manual, hover your mouse over the Applications tab in the toolbar and click Application Forms. Then click the NETStudy 2.0 User Manual link to open it in a new tab.